Okay.
Here comes the boy. Hello, boy. Welcome. There he is.
All right, so we are live. Hello, everybody, and welcome back. This is your one and only Chicken Salad here with Alan Wake. So this is not the remastered version, mind you. So the graphics are probably going to be horrendous, but this is what the game I played. Yes, I guess. Okay. Seems to be having a hard time. Yes, just give it a minute. We're gonna kick in. There we go. Before we do any of that, make sure we got the game capture. All right, so this is Alan Wake. Straight into it. Oh, very good, very good. Check the options. Definitely gotta go to graphics. Very good. VSync off. I don't think we need VSync. Advanced options, please. Graphics quality medium. Hell no. Let's go high. Hello, the grass distance. Yeah, grass distance don't really care about. We should be able to do a high. If it starts to lag, let me know. And I'll try to do something about it. Subtitles enabled for sure. Video commentary? Maybe not. Controls. Let's just check the controls. Key bindings. WASD, shift control to walk. Okay. E to exit or exit minigame. R to reload. Jump. There's minigames? Shoot. Middle mouse button to throw. No, I think not. Flashlight. Q to reload. F to focus. Man, I do not remember these buttons. Manuscript is F5. Pistol, flare gun, flashbang. Tab, okay. So I don't like that. I think throw. G. That should be, Is there a reset? Oh, enter accept. Out. I guess out. No, out will be acceptable. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna quickly change my controller settings, my mouse to editing. Maybe that's gonna be better. Okay, so instead, so out. I'm thinking maybe delete. Would be a good idea. Delete throw. F to focus. I don't like the idea of to focus, but we'll leave it at that for now. Go back to keyboard and make sure it's done. Controls, vertical sensitivity, it should be fine. Direct aiming. I don't know what that means. I was considering playing this on controller, but I don't think that's wise. Got some extras. Stats, playback credits, okay. Episodes. I'm as blocked, okay. Well, we're gonna do a new game. So this will be Alan Wake. I hope you guys enjoy this as much as I do. So without any further ado, let's begin. I'm gonna play normal.
This Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Is it me, or is this the game really soft?
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird. Even
look, I think the game's a bit soft, so I'm just gonna. It's already maxed for everything, so I'm gonna just increase it here. 8.6 sounds pretty good. Even by my standards. Oh, it's so much louder now. We'll quit the menu. Except. So I kind of just. Kind of want the whole sequence again. I'm also just going to double check that I'm actually live. Yep. Definitely live. Okay, let's do it then. Alright, okay.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be.
It's still very soft.
They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation.
Sorry, guys. So sorry. I still think that's pretty soft. I kind of want it to be not too soft. If I did it like this.
The unanswered mystery is what stays.
I mean, I feel like that's probably a little bit better. Remember in the end. This 6.8. Alright, so I'm just gonna. I do apologize. We're gonna do this again. I just wanna hear the game, you know.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations.
I like how they introduced Stephen King. Fear.
In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why. But there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
It's a very interesting cut.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Oh. Oh.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
That's why you should drive the speed limit, bud.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Wait, who's Alice?
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Episode 1, Nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Okay, look up to the light. Do you reverse controls for looking up and down? No. Change this camera setting in the menu option. Okay, so this is the tutorial. I'm just going to turn VSync on because I think I'm seeing screen tearing, which is a shame. Oh man, that sensitivity is crazy high. Let's decrease it a bit more, decrease it a bit more, decrease it a bit more. That seems a bit more manageable. So I love about these new like gaming mouses so that I can like decrease it on the fly. I don't know. Any other, like, what do you call it? Any other, back in the my days, that was not a thing. You know how annoying that is? Get in and out and change the DPI. Alright, let's do that. Shift to sprint. What the? Yeah, it's my books! Alan Wake.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
To the lighthouse. Can I fall and die here? That says yes.
Stephen King once wrote that outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. I was in shock from the crash.
Okay, thank you.
I hardly stand my feet.
Okay, thank goodness we can skip. Oh my god. Oh my god, is that gonna be my stats? Okay, there's no stats for death. Thank goodness. No. Okay, good to know you can die. Say your line.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked.
Okay, checkpoint reached. Or not.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me.
Yep, I understand, Alan. I understand. Just, you know, looking around. Checking for, you know what. Some of this, some cool stuff. Oh, it's Alan. I was wondering if he was like panting. I don't know if there's anything up here. I was intrigued that like... Oh my god, dude, I think I can... I probably should, but I think I can glitch this game. Shouldn't be hard to do. They're letting me explore quite a few areas. Wait, that's just straight up death. Yeah, I probably should stop doing this. And actually play the game. Okay. Cool. Rain Cove Point. Verb. What's that? So there's missing people. Can't search the dumpster. Good to know. Welcome to Night Springs, population 2589. I see shinies.
It collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
One collectible thermos, 1 out of 100. Get out of here. Yeah, we're gonna try, but we're not gonna like try, if that makes sense. We'll collect if we see it. Oh. Hello there, friendo. Got a critic here.
Not like your story's already good. Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me! Look at your work!
Yeah, fuck you! You and your critics. You can have your own opinions. Don't push it onto others. Say a piece and move on. Now I'm gonna like look for. Oh. QR code for anybody that wishes to do the QR code. I don't exactly know where it goes. But if it rickrolls you, please let me know. That'd be hilarious. Dodge enemy attacks.
Damn.
Shift and that way, okay.
You can't stop me.
Try to dodge attack. Alright, guess we gotta try to dodge it.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
That's a good realization. Don't fall.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
I can say not very good. Ah! Run, buddy, run. I must be tired. Time to run. I'm coming, but I'm tired.
Hurry!
This guy's got no stamina. I don't know who you are. I'm going.
Oh no! Stop! No! Damn it, die! No!
You got two bullets. Hellish nightmare did you bring us? Ooh. Yes, I remember the televisions. Look around for some stuff. Yes. We'll get out. Oh, okay. It's actually hurting me.
Follow the light.
Oh, that's the light.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Go into safe haven. Oh, the light heals.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Very helpful.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Oh man, those thermos is gonna get me
this
killed.
Way, there's no time.
Yes, you say there's no time, but there's collectibles, so there's always time.
You must follow me now. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Ooh.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
This was the mechanic that I really enjoyed in the game.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Got the gun. Dude, how many shots do you need?
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Oh my god, the gun is like loud ass. Let's get ammo. Okay, 42, answer the life. I can't run often because I feel like that's when I die. Yep. How about that, bitch? Kill me now. So I thought. Now we're gonna go back. Get some more ammo. Because I can. Didn't know there was a way here, though. Makes me wonder if there's any collectibles. This is how I'm gonna die. It's not the enemies, it's me searching for collectibles. Oh! Look at that! I didn't know you could do that over here. Alright, let's jump over. Wonder if this gives me an achievement or something. Gave me nothing. I feel like that should have gave me an achievement. Not that it matters, but I feel like it should have. It's kind of cool playing your old childhood games, because it makes you kind of remember what it used to be like back in the days. Aha! Eat it, you piece of shit! Can I actually climb back? Because I would like to get more ammo. I guess I don't need to climb back, there is a way here. And yes, this is how I used to play back then as well. I'm like, no, I need max ammo. It's not too far away, right? Why not? I shouldn't be wasting my time like this. I don't have time to burn. He really does not have stamina. I don't remember him having this low stamina. Flare gun ammo. And a flare gun. Remember the flare gun. Oh, what the hell?
Just like
so this is the power of the flare gun. Look at that. Boom! This makes it powerful. These guys are weak against light, essentially. Oh man, I kind of wanted to see what was in here. I feel like there might have been a secret or something. I don't understand why I can't climb up. What if I can load a checkpoint? Is that a checkpoint? Yes, okay, good. I'm gonna kind of go down here. Yes, I knew it. Secret thermos. We only got 3 shots, so we gotta be mindful, but at the same time. Boom! So sick. So one of the main things is I see a lot in the Steam comments, they're hating the dodge mechanic. I always wanted to know, like, how long would it take for me to just, like, normally do this? I guess it's... I mean, it's respectable. Oh, shit. Fuck this, man. I think I'm just wasting ammo here. By killing these guys.
I can keep this up forever.
I'd like to see you try, buddy. I better run. Run! Is that what the barrel's for? Let me know. The thermos there? Oh. Let's collect the thermos first. Okay, it's getting a bit close. Sorry. Woo! Now he's screwed.
He's here. Alan, wake up. Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
The mouth.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
It's just such a weird smile. I can't tell if that's a design choice or something else. Man, the resolution of these videos. Welcome to Bright Falls. What an apt name. Low res. That high graphics.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife.
Thank you.
If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station.
Ooh.
Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet.
Wow, I didn't need to be that mean. in terms of his tone. He just said, yeah, I'm on holiday, so hope you don't mind.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry. Damn. Yuppies.
Excuse me?
I'm going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here.
Nice town.
Come on, let's get back to the car.
Yeah, let's get back to the car. Oh, wait. I'm driving, right?
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Mm-hmm.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
Okay.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Come on, you can be a little bit nicer, right?
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
That's nice.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
I mean... Thermos.
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
Wow. I just hope it's not copyright music, though.
Yes, that's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented has-been.
It does that.
Get
stuck. Yeah. Jeez. You need to give it a good solid whack. Tune number 6 in the jukebox.
Children of the Elder God. Now there's a song for you.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Yeah. Let them deal with that. Alright, so oh wow, it's gonna make me walk all the way around, okay. Is that guy just floating? Is he like stuck to the wall? 68th annual D-Fest. That's kinda cool. Some low poly. So I think people pointed out that this is like a little bit of reflection of Twin Peaks as well. Hey there, bud. Can I help you?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
So, you know, if you ever watch Twin Peaks, reminds me of that lady with the log.
This is what happens when you get sloppy.
She got quite a few lights.
Do my rounds. Remind them to change their bulbs always. To stay vigilant. Darkness never sleeps.
Oh, well. Let's see if she has one more line. Doesn't seem like she does. Ah, here we go.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it.
Ooh.
Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Creepy. Very creepy. In there, bud. Creepy lady's freaking me out.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Okay. Any other words of wisdom you want to bestow onto Ellen? Or myself? Oh. Alright then.
I am so happy this could be arranged.
Alright, you do you, lady. You do you.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Vigilant as always.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn, aren't you? It swells up like a balloon if I lift it. Then every of them is boom. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
I changed it to you.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Okay. Why do I need to know this? Any more nuggets of wisdom? No? Let's get out of here.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Smart.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That can't be good.
It was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
Clear night, so you folks in the big city look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you? It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Ivor's Isle.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness.
Oh.
I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Let's admire it. I mean...
Are you sure you read the directions right?
Yeah.
It's nothing like in the brochure. It said near the lake, not on it. Don't
That's
get me wrong.
True.
This is so much better. It's wonderful. Our own private island.
Oh, actually. That is very cool. Just want to check around, see if there's any more thermoses. I hate that my brain automatically goes, yep, you gotta look for stuff. I wonder if there's like a invisible wall or a soft lock. It goes, hey, I need to go back to the cabin. No, it's literally letting me run all the way. That's insane. Most games will be like, oh, you reached a certain marker or area. It's like, yep, go back. Or it will be like, I probably really should get her inside before it gets dark, kind of thingy.
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg.
Yeah.
Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
That's not safe at all. Yeah, that's why they let you go all the way up here. See, they keep rewarding you for exploring. That's why I keep wanting to do it. I'm assuming that's the cabin up there. Unless, if my memory serves me well, that might be a mental health retreat. Unless I'm thinking of a different game. Private property, no trespassing. Like, it would be kind of cool to be on a place like this. I'll admit. Having a cabin like a little island in the middle of the lake. Just get your fishing rods out. Fish. It'll be very cool. I'll have like a little boat. Pretty. Alright. Ready to go in, darling? Let's go. Ah, oh, crap. Well, let the lady do all the heavy lifting, eh? I wonder if I can fall in here. Oh, you can't? Oh my god, they introduced invisible walls. Interesting. Maybe not in all areas. Oh no, they did. I thought the beginning area didn't have invisible walls. Did they just expect people to just follow the line? There's invisible walls. Impressive. Shoot, bird, shoot! Bird leg cabin.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Well, first things first. We gotta explore every nook and cranny. Those damn thermoses.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Might be mixing up with the movie Brood.
old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Let's start it then. Let there be light. Get generator running. Nice. Nice.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
I have a feeling I wasn't supposed to do that.
It's a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest.
Okay, let's just restart checkpoint.
It's something, all right.
I'm assuming the thermos is already picked up.
I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know.
I'm just gonna check the stats. So the thermos should already be picked up. 5 out of 100?
I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness.
Let's just double check.
I wanted to make sure we were inside with
that way we don't have to really do this whole thing again. This might be a pain for now, but it doesn't matter. What am I doing? Yeah, fuck it. Even if you didn't get it, who cares? We shouldn't be wasting time like this. I've got so many other games to play. I don't want to rush the experience, but at the same time, I don't want to waste time on frivolous things. Who cares about collectibles? As much as I do care about it, I gotta convince myself otherwise. Shoot, bird, shoot! Shoot! Come back, Nick.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Oh, going through some hard times, bud. How's the game? Eh, it's not too bad.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
It's giving me some nostalgia vibes, but it's. I remember playing this as a child, so I barely remember a lot of the things in this game. I think my brain's like mixing different memories together, so I'm not even sure what memories relate to this game.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Let's do it. Thank you for the stretch! Oh my god, that unlocking is a minigame as well?
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it.
Yep. On it. Yeah, I jumped the gun by exploring.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Hello? Anyone here?
Yeah.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Okay. But I want to explore the house a bit more. Schubert! Shoot! I don't know why, but that stupid song's in my head. I wanna sing it.
Our best guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less.
Wow.
We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFFM.
He didn't keep his mouth shut at all.
Hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my favorite writer.
Sure, he's glad to be here too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Maine on KBFFM. And now some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Exactly. I knew it was gonna keep his low profile. Just make sure you never have an interview with that guy. Because he clearly cannot be trusted.
The water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
What they say, stare into the abyss long enough. It's this. might not like what comes stares back at you. Something like that. Definitely butchered the saying there. Hey, Beck, let me know if the game's too loud or too soft. In contrast to me voice. Your lovely voice!
The oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Whoa. Okay.
Damn.
Good to know that there's jump scares in this game. I totally forgot about that.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
Your wife has already told you there's a thing outside? Yeah. You're not gonna comment on that, Alan? You comment on everything. Not this? Okay, so it looks like we can... Maybe we need like a diver's bell or something. We need to go deep. Get the bubs.
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
The alarm's a bit too high. Okay. Alright, let me just drop the audio a bit. So, it's 8.3. It's is that better?
There's probably a fuse box or a generator in the shed.
Yes. Yes, there is. We got a minigame.
The generator had been connected to the power cable.
Yeah, let's do it. Look at that dial, man. It's so cartoonish.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Oh.
I thought we could be happy here.
You thought wrong. Turn to Alice. Yeah, so it doesn't do the thing. Okay, interesting. Really like if I can turn off that weird motion blur effect. Generator's running. We have light.
Alice? Honey?
Temple of Shadow and Mist, the labyrinth of me. In her dreams to prevail, kept from sleep. Some hints, maybe? Some hints?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Ooh, you know I like my surprises. Oh, it's getting misty. Oh, hello. Hello. Let me just freshen up myself.
Surprise.
Alice, what is this?
I guess I have a small confession.
I went to the wrong room. We're gonna restart checkpoint. We went to the wrong room. It's giving you Mia and Ethan. Yeah, it kind of does, doesn't it?
Alice? Honey?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
What do you mean chicken bonk? Don't bonk me. Oh, hello there, baby. How are you doing?
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Baby, you always my surprise. Let's have a look around here. Any more dialogue? No? What's that? Bright Falls record. Lake. A local park ranger. Forest no more dangerous than usual. Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past-
Damn it, Alice! You- Everyone
hey,
keeps-
Hey, hey, hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Whoa.
So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not-
What was that?
Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Damn it. Alice?
Dude. Go. Run!
Had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Is there a person just there in front of me?
Alan, where are you? Help!
What
Alice,
the hell? Oh!
It's all right. I'm coming.
Fuck you, birds!
What the hell?
Okay, burst dissipated.
No! Oh no!
Other group of burbs. I'm coming, Dolly!
Alice? Alice?
Jump in, you fool!
No!
From one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Oh, damn. What happened here?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Yeah, let's have a look around. There's only one real entry or exit.
Hmm. gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
What is that sound? Oh, it's electricity. Okay. Interesting.
Damn.
Oh. Oh, there goes my car. Hopefully we got everything we needed. Yeah, it's just a death pit here. The light. Hello, Mr. Light. Ah.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh. You found manuscript pages. You can access them with the F5 button. Title.
Departure by Alan Wake.
How do I turn the page?
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Bum, bum, bum! Ooh, and there's fire. Okay, so we got 8 pages we need to find. Okay. So there's even more collectibles. Great. That's just, you know. That's when I thought I couldn't have enough more. Can't have enough collectibles. I gotta get more. Let's just follow the path first. We deviate too far. I'm probably gonna end up missing a lot of things. I'm gonna look around for goodies. I'm always gonna look for collectibles.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
That is true. Seems like we gotta go up there. Anything of interest around here? Hoping they're making it easier for me to collect. I wonder. I guess not. Okay, there is 4 damage. Gotta be careful for that. Damn, there's nothing. I feel like I can use this and abuse the physics somehow. Probably shouldn't. Just play it normally.
Huh.
moment.
This cannot be good.
Hey, hey you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation.
Deposit required. Fair and square.
Oh, okay, freaky, freaky. Bullshit, I can't get up on this thing. There we go. Ah, invisible walls. Never mind. Oh, manuscript. So look. Wake fights a taken with light.
The taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Ooh. That certainly wasn't nice. I wonder if I can go through here. Oh, there it is, Thermos. You good? We're not in a good situation right now. A secret in here. Oh my god.
Shit. It's the latest thing.
Here's Johnny.
A way out of this. Any second now and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Did you really say Energizer? My god, ad placement. Hello? Batteries!
During your recording, trying it's the latest thing. Incontestably proven health benefit lets you
kill.
One stone. You can see the sights and keep those cholesterol levels
down
at the same
time.
Okay. Thank you for the tip.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. Only I.
Ah.
Hello?
God damn it. Never be easy, eh?
This is bad.
Oh. 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 Oh! Get out! Woo! Goodbye! Was acting like rent is due.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
No, let's move. Let's get out of here. Why, thank you. Oh, no, thank you. That's right. Ha!
I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Oh yeah, there was this flashlight mechanics. Flashlight mechanics are fun, and the paint. Love how unhinged the guy is? Yeah. They're all unhinged. Maybe I shouldn't have done that.
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Yes, flare gun, let's go. Flare gun's so good. Oh man, me looking for collectibles is gonna be the most annoying thing for me. Alright, checkpoint reached. Oh, I thought that was explosive. Whoa! Fuck you! Throw that shit at me! Oh, emergency. Oh, batteries, revolver ammo. Very nice. I would have preferred flare ammo, but take what I can get. I thought those barrels were explosive. What a shame. Manuscript? 5? Okay.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
So Rose was the waitress in the diner? And you're frustrated collecting collectibles is funny. But it's so annoying because there's a part of me that goes, you have to collect it. And another part of me is like, but I've got no time! I got hundreds of games to play and I can't be stuck on playing this one. Know what I mean? You know what I mean? There's so many other games to play. Also don't want to like lose the experience of it, playing this game. Because when I played it as a child, I remember collecting like pretty much everything. Fucking bad!
Was that?
Whatever it was, wasn't pleasant. Is that how you want it? I guess.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
But I'm looking at the water. Looks odd. Definitely a collectible around here. Guess not. No! I knew it! My collectible finding abilities were tingling. I don't even know what happens when you collect it all anyways. Alright, anyone in chat? Beck? Can you find me the reason why I should bother collecting any of these things? Actually, no, don't search it, because I don't want you to get any spoilers. I'm gonna search it. I'm gonna search real quickly. Is there any point to collecting any of these things? Because if there isn't, then I'm not gonna bother. What do you mean, yes? Alan Wake. What happens if I collect all collectibles? Question mark. I don't want you to like get I don't want you to get spoiled. So the pages only provide more detail. All other collectibles are purely for completionist achievement purposes. Okay, thank goodness. Okay, cool. So we don't need to collect if we don't want to. Alright, so I'm gonna do the poor man's collecting. So I might look around, but I won't look too hard. Hello there, buddy.
Stucky was still out there in the dark.
I'm stucky. Manuscript! Is it Barry's arrival? Wait, how much more is there? Oh, there's a lot
Barry
more.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Good on, Barry! Thank you, Barry. Something is very wrong. This whole town is fucked. Oh, yeah, there's also Twin Peaks, what do you call it? Homages in this game. See if you can see them out. I know we've only watched like two episodes, but see if you can spot them. Oh, shiny. Batteries. We gotta watch more Twin Peaks. I heard something back. Oh god. Fuck you! Bloody crazed fans. You know what's annoying? They make it that the dodge function is run and direction and shift, which shift is also run. But the downside of running like that is that this guy has really low stamina, so if you continually run, your ability to regain the stamina is really poor. Well, you can try, I guess. Oh, this way. Yes. All the magic arrows. It's not in here, is it? Magic arrows. Head out whenever you watch it. It's because you're trying to decipher it while you're watching. Just enjoy it. What a crazy ride it is.
They're taken.
The taken are filled with darkness. With darkness, I say. Darkness. Hello. Batteries. Alright, so I'm gonna spam my focus ability. We got 20 batteries. Pretty sure I'm maxed out. I'm kind of curious what's over here, though. A lot of nothing. Okay. I do remember in the game that I played I remember running around a lot in the game as a child. Whether or not he gets tired or not, didn't matter to me. Yes, didn't really matter.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Maybe, get that light. Fix it. Oh, hello. Roll Vamo's maxed. Okay. Oh, what's this?
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Is this... No. We call it there's like a cable. What the? Okay, I thought it was a head. Just a helmet. Just a helmet. I might as well climb up this. Okay, random helmet. Oh, thermos. Generators over there.
Forestry equipment around. There had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Get the thermos first. If we see it, we collect it. If we don't, then so be it. Die! Fuck you guys! Oh my god, almost got killed there. Dodged, bitch! Ah! Probably could have used a flare there. Let there be light! Very good, very good. Assuming all the Taken would now spawn. Be asses. Another manuscript. Wake attacked by birds.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Yes, the birds are evil in this. Oh, shotgun, hello! I only got 2 bullets though. I have to actually move it. Damn. I'm assuming there's gonna be some... No? I keep thinking there's gonna be like an event each one, every time I do one of these things. I guess they're placed around strategically, which is the smart thing to do. Not too much that it's predictable, but not it. But enough to make things interesting. Oh my god! Alright, maybe we don't have to jump. Nope, definitely gotta jump. I can't remember if we can, like, increase our HP, though. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? Whee! Long jump. That jumps terribly, though. No! Oh my god, I almost fell! Alright, anything up here? I feel like these things are, like... I don't know, I feel like there's like something about them you can do.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. To the listeners, no, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Oh, I think Toby's dead. Or converted. Oh, hello there, beautiful. Another flag on ammo. Very good, very good. That reminds me, there was some ammo down there. It'll probably collect it. I mean, it's only a little bit of bullets. I'm not gonna go all the way just for the little bit of bullets. That's just insane. Another manuscript. Where's this guy, man?
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Interesting. Alright. Let's go. Let's go, Alan. Gotta save Alice.
The gas station was closer now. It's light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the street. Barry Master is the best with no dogs. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Okay. I mean, I think we're pretty much established that they're all crazy. Not good. Where? Oh. Oof. Fuck you. Fuck you too. Oh. Oh. That was my first hit. I see a manuscript. I need it. TV gas station.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Damn. Officially losing his mind. Wait. Okay. I wonder what that was. What? I wonder, is this the way I'm supposed to go? Yeah, it looks like it. Alright, if that's the way I'm supposed to go, I'm gonna go back down there. So I wanna kinda explore more of that bottom area. Again. Thermos. Oh! My god, the damage. Is that really nothing? Power off. Expected it to explode, man. A generator. Gotta go to the generator. I see them. Eat it! Yeah, that's what I thought, bitches. Safe haven. You don't really just come back for like a thermos. That's annoying. Just fire. You think you can get me, punk? Oh. Safe haven. Run, boy, run! Oh, thing for the hydrate and stretch. Ooh. Oh, that's a good stretch. Ooh, very good stretch. Kind of like Evil Within? Yeah. Oh, there's no coming back now. Okay, whatever your name is, Stucky or something. Oh, flare gun. Yes, I love flare gun. Watch me hoard all these items and never use them. Oh, that's so weird. Why did the rocks fall there? I don't think I can shoot the birds. Bitch! Boom! That's why the flare gun's so good. If there's ever three in a group, I'm always gonna use it. The flare gun. Always. Lithium batteries, thank you. Oh, shotgun! Yes! Shotgun ammo, please! Hoping to get this out of the way. Oh well. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment. Known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did.
I think I remember this bit where it's like he ends up shooting himself though. Reality is always
the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do.
Yeah, this is the bit.
The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps.
Yep, this was the episode.
Crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
It's kind of like the Twilight series. I really like that. I think that's what I liked about Alan Wake a lot, was the fact that it merges a lot of different shows and authors that I enjoy. That's what made it fun.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Twilight. Oh, that's not safe. Alright, let's see. Did that do anything? Are they gonna spawn in soon?
Triggers!
Is this boss battle? They gave me a box of infinite ammo there. Well, not infinite ammo, but I can always go back and collect it. These barrels are empty. Red barrel doesn't mean explosive barrels. God damn it. Why the red? Starkey? Is that you? Did say I'll use it. Oh! Did I really only kill one of them? God damn it. Shotgun time. Hey, buddy. How fast are you? He's stuck there. There we go. Woo.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Yeah, I can see why people didn't like the dodge mechanics. On the, at least on the PC, it's very, very annoying. Because you gotta press shift and direction. Can't just hold direction and shift. You have to press shift and direction. And when he gets tired, he can't dodge anymore. And he's got such a small stamina pool. So you're gonna, if you dodge too frequently, you're gonna get screwed. I think that's why you gotta manage your resources carefully as well, obviously. Alright. Open sesame. That wasn't too bad. I mean, the shotgun did a lot of damage. That was pretty good. I'll admit, I don't feel the tension I once felt as a child. Then again,
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Can I not use controller? I probably could. But then I lose the ability to aim. Oh, not that you really need to aim in this game. As long as you got the light at the enemy, you can just keep pressing the shoot button and auto-shoot them.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Love, there's so many checkpoints in this game.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Oh man, so that's how he got taken over.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Damn, son. It's quite the bender you've been through. A 100 thermoses and it doesn't do anything. Yeah, I still collect them.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right, I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Yes. Yes, you are.
Brightfall Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Big reveal. That's right.
A candy-colored clown, they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night. And just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper.
End of episode one.
Everything is all right. I close my eyes.
That's right. It's episodic. So we're gonna do one every day until we finish the game. Isn't this cool? This is how I edit my videos. Well, back in the days when I did this story once. I just hope none of this music is copyright. Back in my days. Alright, think I have to.
Previously on Alan Wake, I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Episode 2. Taken. New York City 3 years ago. Yep, exactly. Resident Evil, Alien Isolation. That's how I do my edits. Because I've always wanted to, like, work on TV shows.
Honey,
and movies.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
But I see coffee right ahead.
Hey, handsome. This is gonna be a
beautiful
long night, but these shots are turning out great.
I guess you're gonna need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
But... Oh, would you look at that? It's me. Oh, so she's a photographer. And she's afraid of the dark. Interesting. Okay. There's one awkward hand. But which hand are you talking about? Alright, so Here's a question. We can probably end it here. And we probably would. Yes. And we'll just continue off next time. Hand in the bag. Oh. Let's confirm quit. Earlier? Oh, okay. I didn't see it. Oh, I don't remember it. But yeah, that was Alan Wake, Episode 1, Nightmare. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Isn't that interesting? How interesting was that? I think that's also why I loved the game as a kid, because it felt like a TV show and I'm playing through. Interesting, yeah. I think also it was the first time experiencing the light mechanics, because I'm so used to just shooting things, right? Bullet hits enemy, they go, wah. But in this game, you have to like do something extra. I mean, obviously other like AAA FPSs, there's like shields and other things that you have to get around, but it felt fresh with using the light versus darkness, and also the, you know, the symbolic aspects of the game as well, which we'll might delve in a little bit if we get the time. Anywho, that's it for episode 1 of Alan Wake. Do come in, watch me on Twitch to see it all live. You can, if you are watching this, you're most likely watching this on my second channel. If you do, don't forget to hit the like button. If you did like it, comment down below to help the channel grow and share it around, and hopefully you'll steal the show. There's also links in the descriptions for YouTube and Twitch, or the primary YouTube channel. Do check me out there as well. Bullet hits enemy, they go, wow, chicken salad. <That's anything. laughs> Yeah. Anyways, with that, hope you guys did enjoy it. And as always, take it easy. Until next adventure, I'll see you there. Thanks for watching. Bye now! And for all you veteran viewers and Silent Family members, I'll see you guys on theater. Just gonna grab some dinner. And we'll continue off with our movie night. Or TV night, or whatever we are doing on theater. Was my ice